Hey, second grade, I am so excited about today's lesson. Let me tell you, the next video, it was an adventure. So let's talk about all the fun things that we are going to review today and do today. Our topic, if you didn't notice by our heading here, is kite flying. So excited for this. So we've got two learning targets today. One, I can fly a kite to learn about the wind. And two, I can use weather tools to help me fly a kite. So let's break down what that means. One, our keywords that we've had going on here. Meteorologist, that's all of us. We're all people who study weather. Thermometer is something that we use to measure the temperature. We've talked about our rain gauge to measure the rain. Clouds are things that are in the sky that are big water droplets. There are three types. And then our last focus that we've had the last couple of days is the wind. And we know the wind blows things around. Even though we can't always see the wind, we can see the wind blowing different things. So focusing on wind today, we're going to talk all about flying a kite and how the wind affects kite flying. So there are two tools that I'm going to use when I am talking about kite flying. One, I'm going to make my kite. And in the first part of my experiment, I did not use my weather tools to help me fly the kite, and it shows. But then in my second attempt, I use the tool that we actually made last week. So I'm going to show you, Holden in Miss Thoreau's class actually brought his into school for me today. And this is his wind vane. Excellent job. And the wind vane here, as we talked about, it spins in the direction of the wind. And this helped me in kite flying because I can use it to tell what direction the wind is blowing. And then from there, I can hold my kite in that direction. So this can really help me. Another thing is an anemometer, and this would have been really helpful to help me decide the speed of the wind. All right, let's break down what we got for the rest of the day today. On our next slide, you have the actual experiment. It's a good one. And can you spy Henry the dog in the video? And then our exit ticket today is, does it take more or less wind, using those math words, to fly a kite than to move a bubble? Does it take more or less wind to fly a kite than to move a bubble? Why and how do you know? You can either type it on the slide or you can put it in your science journal. Good luck, second grade. I will see you later, meteorologists, on the next slide.